Hey guys, how you doing? It's Monday. It's been a glorious, boring day at work. And it was truly boring. So I got some time in between drawing my sketchbook, just a little bit here and there. But I still have to get into the swing of things of doing these new phone calls that I have to do. Apart from that, I'm really excited to get home now and see if I can get up to, well, I'm never gonna make 6 hours because it's probably gonna be like 5:30 before I get home. And 6 will be midnight. I could, but the aim is 6 hours, and I'm just gonna keep aiming for it so that one day. But if I get 4 hours in, I'd be very, very happy. So let's see what happens today, because yesterday I couldn't get all that much done. Like we've been having so many problems at the house with paying bills correctly and making sure the companies allow us to pay them correctly, and making sure they don't cut us off from anything, making sure everyone pays their due, all the people getting sick at the house. Another major issue I've had is just making sure there's enough food for everyone, and I had an infection myself in my mouth all of a sudden, which was not pleasant. But enough about that. Let's race home and fire up the CNT. I want to get started today with doing a little exercise. And the exercise is just taking a comic book and looking at a couple of pages and seeing how these guys, you know, come to solutions. Like, how do they render? Because this one in particular, I've already noticed that, like in this scene right here, if it was me, I would totally render the hell out of all these shades. But this guy, this artist, leaves it to the colorist. You know? I would totally put shadows here. Like, I would draw those shadows. Maybe the artist did and the colorist took over. I don't know. It looks good as it is. But like, these are like little things I'm thinking about, like how do they solve these problems? Like this one, how do you keep the attention on this guy going down? You know? Maybe because you have more contrast here right in the middle? Just something to think about. I would totally be inclined to draw these shadows, not just with a line, but actually like. And another thing I noticed is the word for inker in Spanish. But over here, I just realized that in this case, pour does not mean for, it clearly means by. I didn't know you could do that.
This is the comic book from yesterday. So there's this page, and there's this page. What I've been doing here is just copying that one. I'm not too precious about it, but as you can see, I just want to get a feel.
Proportions on a page, and I just want to, you know, I just want to get started. Like, I just got home, I just want to get started. I'm already slowing down without thinking too much about it, because I've set up the round one rough pencils. I've set up my round two rough pencils in Photoshop in a nice little template so I can redraw them like digitally and tighten things up. And that's gonna, you know, that's gonna be a lot slower because I'll probably start thinking and overthinking. And
about the general feel of like drawing these panels and like putting things in position. And like a thing I noticed here was There's a lot of clutter this guy drew. There's a lot of clutter, and like the way, like I was really paying attention, like how he drew it without, like it's important that it's there as like set dressing, but and like to make the place feel real, but at the same time, like this is where it's at, these two characters, right? So interesting. Interesting little exercise.
All right, let's tackle one of my own pages.
So I'm sticking to the same gist. It's a day in the life. She gets up, she gets dressed, says goodbye, does the round, you know, starts making the coffee, delivers some coffee. We meet another main character, like waking up, goes say hello to some more characters, like her best friend, like get some intimacy going, like they're very, you know, that they're close. Start giving the first inkling of the different classes of characters, different backgrounds, like this is a very well-to-do upper level deck, this is kind of in between, this is very rough, I think I might have to move him over. So let me just show you how I've been resizing everything. So this is how I've been cutting stuff up. This is a bit bigger. This is like skewed. This was over here. I think I might have to put it back. This character I blew up to make it more like in front and more of a background. I still think this is very unclear. At some point I actually thought these two were the same. They're not. So that's not clear. I don't know what I'd put here if like she, like there's a, like, you know, she's getting up, getting dressed, saying goodbye, on the move. So maybe this could be a close-up of her making stuff, or maybe this should just be moved back here. And then over here originally was like the saying hello. I think this should be another shot of her like climbing down some stairs to get here, kind of thing.
An hour has passed. We still have guests at the house, so it's a little tricky, like getting the full night. Have to socialize a little bit. Have to buy some food, have to make dinner, all that stuff. I didn't expect them to be back this early either, so, but that's cool. They're not here all the time. So I have been turning off my Cintiq, and I made this right here. I think it's a little too complicated for its own good, but I kind of like the layout with the panels, you know, like a jigsaw puzzle, and like it's kind of cool. I think I need to simplify it a little bit, but all in all I've had a fun hour moving stuff around, cutting it up, drawing it, and then emphasizing it in black again. It's been cool. It's Tuesday. Yeah. So it's 10 to 9. All I can say is I got home, I raced to get home, I was super pumped. I sat down with my phone in my hand checking social media, and half an hour later I was all like, oh my god, he's doing it. I did a little online searching to see where my very special comic book package is gone. Looks like I'm out of luck. For the second time in a row, dramatic tension, Ox's package has not been delivered and shipped back to the United States. For some reason, they did not drop it off at the depot for me to collect. They did not leave a notice. The next day, deported. So, looks like I'm gonna have to wait a little bit longer for my surprise. Apart from that, I looked at some comics. I've been following up on all the videos I missed out on of the THEE100s Anthology, which is looking really awesome. And now it's time for me to continue what I was doing yesterday. So thinking back about what I did yesterday. So here's a fun experience. I was talking about my comic book Fosphor to my coworker, who's very much into to fantasy movies and whatnot, and writes fanfic and, like, you know, our kind of people. And I told her, like, I had already made a comic book. She was like, oh, I didn't realize that. So I had her read it on my phone. And she gave me a kind of, she gave me the same feedback. And it was kind of funny watching her ask questions and read it and going, am I supposed to read it like this or like this, or like which way am I going? So clarity. It was also kind of, you know, like asking her like what she thought and like talking about all the characters in there. And I know I have a lot of characters, but like, who are they? And like all this stuff in 10 pages didn't make it very clear. And that feedback from today, on my original 10 pages, which you can still read, there'll be a link down below, so you can have a look for yourself. I kind of took it to heart about what I'm doing right now, which is introducing proper characters, showing their day at work, so you can kind of identify with some of them, and just trying to be clear. So I thought of my layout from yesterday, which I really like. I really like it, but at the same time, is it clear? Because I'm already like, well, you know, like over here, she's kind of walking and then she goes to the kitchen and makes the coffees and like, is that clear? So I just wrote down a list of like, this is what happens on page one without any dialogue, any text whatsoever. Is that obvious? So that's how I'm kind of gonna go back at some point to page one, because I want to keep going. But I wrote all that down and I'm keeping that in mind. And then I thought, well, I'm still on page two, and page two, there's extra space for more storytelling. So I'm thinking, instead of trying to come up with something witty on the spot, I'll just leave that blank. So maybe that'll be spillover from page one that isn't clear in hindsight. That's what I'm thinking. But right now, I've got 25 minutes. I'm gonna do a little practicing. I've got Super Crooks, Cintiqué, and 25 minutes to go. So let's see what I can learn from this page. Well, the sign on the wall does say crazy bomb stories. So let me tell you about this one crazy bomb story I have, having lived through the terrorist attacks in London all those years ago. You can imagine in the months after, the city was on high alert. There was military police everywhere, and we had more than a few bomb scares. Like, most of them were just, you know, they became annoyances on your way to work because everyone was being overly vigilant. But there was this one time where I was serving a table in a very big American restaurant, and this car pulled up right in front of the window, and the driver just ran off. I didn't see this myself. The tables did, the tables I was serving. And so they decided to call the police. And of course, I was like, oh my God, no,
You know what this means. Now they're going to seal off the whole block and we're all going to be stuck here. And as we escorted everyone downstairs, another one of my tables from New York, the young girls had a complete meltdown having lived through 9/11 when they were children. And so we had to calm them down and like explain to them like, no, this is happening all the time just because of the attacks like a month ago. And so, you know, it's nothing to worry about. So we're all here just having a good time. And we were down there for about, I'd say like an hour. And little did I know that the police had sent in a robot to blow up the car. And there was a bomb inside. So that's my crazy bomb story for you. And did it make me want to stop working in restaurants or stop going to restaurants? No, of course not. Even the cat is hungry. I bet he wouldn't like a salad though. It also didn't put me off from visiting beautiful places like Istanbul, which suffered terrorist attacks right before I went and right after I went there. And I was totally planning on going back there, but lately they seem to be in the thrall of a president who has purged about, what was the number again? Something ridiculous like 50,000 teachers from their jobs because they might be teaching children things he doesn't agree with. It's crazy. What's even more crazy is, well, this isn't a show about politics. This is about, you know, like showing you what I've been up to drawing. Unfortunately, the wider world can have an impact on our ability to stay focused. As can the sheer lack of food. I think he's fed up with me now. But I guess what I'm trying to say is, or what I'm trying to get across is, you know, there's plenty of reasons to be afraid in the world. And there's definitely a lot of people who are afraid, and with good reason, perhaps. But there's so much, the world is such a big place, and there's so much beautiful art, like I got to see while I was over there, and in other places I've been to. And it'd be such a shame for any of us to miss out on the incredible stories and amazing, just amazing art on display in faraway places. Or worse yet, to never experience the incredible hospitality you'll find in countries like Turkey.
It's a rare treat. Almost completely quiet little square. It doesn't happen very often anymore.
Music video one, because music videos, like productions, have become to the point where they're kind of like a movie. So it's like all these special effects which were...
Hey guys, good morning. How are we? It's Saturday. It's about 10:30. I finally got to sleep in, even though I had to get up very early this morning to send my friend on her journey back to Amsterdam. The clanging in the background, that's the guy selling butane. Gas going from door to door every single day. That's my cue to get out of bed. So what has been happening? Like, so what's been happening is I have been spending a lot of time drawing Fosphor, my comic book, working on the thumbnails, and it's been eating up all my time. Like, I've been obsessing about it, and it's been great, like putting the time in, but it's still not done. And so I'm in this odd, like, man, I really have to get back into the anthology. So I've decided that this weekend I'm not working on Fosphor. I'm only working on the anthology. And then I thought to myself, now that's the old me thinking. Like, I can only do one thing on a day and I have to have the whole day off. It's not true. If I divide my day up, let's say 8 hours to work on art, so it's 10:30. So 8 hours, so giving myself a break for lunch and all that stuff, I should be done at about 6:37. And then that can be for several things, because right now I'm a little, coffee hasn't kicked in yet. So I've put up some Travis Trist art, and I've got a comic book out, and I'm just gonna draw from them and just kinda feel my way around some texturing and like inking digital this time. I also can't find my tripod, but that's a different story. So I'm gonna start off with that just so I don't have to think and just can warm up. And then I'm gonna start on my comic book. I'm gonna go for a run. I'm gonna eat, I'm gonna work more. By then I'll probably have a good idea what I wanna do for the anthology comic book today. And then somewhere along the line, I'm gonna do some other stuff as well, some other art related stuff. But 8 hours, let's see if I can make it. In case you haven't noticed, there's been an explosion in new videos from the new members of the THEE100s. There's lots of people taking on the challenge that I got to do last year. If you're not aware of what this is, it's kind of how I really got started. Like, before the 100 days of making comics, I was making videos about making video games and like the stuff I was learning online related to that, the odd music video I made from when I was living in Bogota, Colombia, visiting my friend's jazz cafe. Might have to put a link up. There's some really good tunes there, actually. But yeah, there's a lot of new people making lots and lots of videos. And of course, in their videos, at some point, the topic does turn to making videos. And combining that topic with the last Artcasters I saw, which was all about what's in your portfolio, I kind of started thinking, like, well, I want my portfolio to be the two comics I'm making this year, Fosphor and the 100 Days of Making Comics anthology, the 6-page short story based around the theme of life in space. I kind of want those to be my new portfolio and want to send them out. But thinking about portfolio in a different way, I am almost up to 200 videos, which I can't believe I've actually, that I'm about to reach 200 videos. That's just crazy. But in a way, you know, anyone who were to look me up now is going to find these videos, and I guess in some way they are my portfolio right now. They are kind of what it is that I'm doing right now for everyone to see. And so thinking about it in that way, I decided to kind of step up just a little bit and start making some decent thumbnails. So here's one attempt at making decent thumbnails. I got a little carried away, which is why it's in this video, because I thought it'd be fun to look at me paint on top of a Photoshop filtered picture of myself. You know, why not? Just this once. But yeah, I've started paying a little bit more attention to my thumbnails. And also, by doing that, I noticed I have quite a few new subscribers. I guess I have the Artcasters and Mike's stream to thank for that.
being on those shows since then, there's been a healthy little increase. I'm only at like 72 as we speak, but for me, that's twice as much as where I was just, you know, 2 months ago. So if you're new and you're watching this and you've managed to make it past the 25 minute mark, thanks for watching. Thanks for joining. If you have any questions, of course, as always, feel free to leave them down below. I'll try and get back to you as soon as I can. I am probably in a different time zone, but you never know. Let me know where you're from. Let me know what you're into. If you're into making comics, feel free to just leave a comment so I can find my way to your channel and check out what you're doing. And yeah. With that, I'm going to close off this video because it's getting, it's midnight already. And I have to get up about 7, which is not too bad. 7 hours is pretty decent. But this video still has to render. I'm still going to have to add a little bit of music here and there. And then it's time for the very long 6-hour upload. And I do want my phone to be ready by the time I go to work, after all. So yeah, I feel like for all the stuff I put in this video, I still feel like I'm actually missing chunks that I plan to put in. But that's a whole nother, I guess I'll just have to save them for another day. So yeah, the drawing you're looking at right now is my friend Alex, one of my coworkers from London, who came to visit with his girlfriend this past week. It's been a bit crazy. Like, I think four people have visited already. And then my best friend is back to Amsterdam after almost two weeks here. I've got another friend visiting, another very, very good friend visiting tomorrow. So that probably means we go out. Ah, timekeeping. That's something. Well, I'm not gonna go in there because there's no light right now and anything, but put a calendar up on the wall and I've been keeping track of how many hours I actually put in, because some of the little clips I put in today are me talking about like trying to hit 6 hours, 8 hours. Well, that didn't quite happen. I definitely tried and I got close. I'm averaging on weekdays at about 3 to 4 hours, and there's the odd 5. And on the weekends, I'm at 6 hours, not the 8 I wanted. Today, I didn't reach it because all of a sudden, I decided to have lunch with one of my best friends here, my old flatmate, Javi. So we got to meet up. And yesterday, I had a slow start, but I did manage to put in 5 hours working on the anthology, which is great, which is a separate video, by the way. If you do want to check that out, I re-thumbnailed 6 pages after a surprise hangout with Kevin Cross on his Patreon, which was awesome. I got to ask him like how he does his thumbnails and all that stuff. I don't know if that's up on his regular YouTube or it's just going to be an exclusive for his Patreons. But yeah, you should totally check him out. And there's quite a few artists I support on Patreon. If you're not familiar with Patreon, you probably have heard of it. But it's a great way of supporting your own favorite artists and, you know, help them build up a little bit of income, because making videos, very time consuming, making all this art, you know, bills do have to be paid. And so if you're following artists that sell prints, check out what they have. You never know. There might be that perfect birthday gift you never thought of for your mom or a loved one or a fellow geek like us. And or you could just support them directly on Patreon and get all the very cool behind the scenes stuff, very lengthy videos, exclusive looks behind like how they make stuff and hang out with them, you know. It's cool. I love it. Other shout outs I do want to give at the end of this video is Ox is doing his 7th Kickstarter. If you don't know who Ox is, I'll put a link up in that little corner thingy information button. Ox has always been very supportive of what I've been up to,
at my videos, and this is my chance to return the favor because obviously I look up to the guy. He's 7 issues ahead of me. And that's quite something, the amount of work he puts in and the fact that he's putting them out like consistently on his own with the support of friends, family, and people like us on YouTube who watch his videos. So it's a crazy world out there. Who knows what you might be putting out? Whatever you put out, let's keep things positive. Even if the work is scary. Like, what was that comic book I read the other day? I actually gave it to my friend to read. The Untold Horror by Jonathan Vicks. I'm butchering his name now. Yeah, that's creepy stuff. You might not think of it as positive, but you know, I do. Getting that stuff out there is good for you. All right, guys, I'm rambling. I think it's, I'm getting tired and, you know, the caffeine is talking now. So hope you all have a great week. Stay away from the news and I'll see you next time.